Y'all, don't miss the revelation in this passage of scripture. Watch this. The very thing she counted as nothing was the very thing that God used as the instrument of her deliverance. I'm going to say that again. The very thing that she said was nothing was the very thing that God used as the instrument of her deliverance. Look at verse 2. So Elisha said to her, "What shall I do for you? What do you have in the house?" And she said, "Your maidservant has what? Nothing but a jar of oil." Now wait a minute. Do you have nothing or do you have a jar of oil? Look at the perception. I asked you, what do you have in the house? You said nothing but a jar of oil. The devil wants you to overlook the thing that's right in front of your face, and the thing that America is missing, the thing that Chicago is missing, the thing that your life is missing, is the power of God. And the devil don't want you to come into the house because he don't want you to get no power. Y'all, this lady, they coming to take her kids because she don't got money to pay the debtors. She said, "Your face servant has nothing. They're coming to take my sons." Well, what do you have? Oh, the jar was sitting right there. She overlooked it and said it was nothing. Not knowing that that was the very thing that was going to bring about her deliverance. Y'all, we look at church like it's nothing. We look at what God wants to tell us like it's nothing. We look at work. Listen, this is the thing you've been praying for. This is the wisdom that you need. This is the strength to overcome addiction. This is healing for your family. This is to affair-proof your marriage. And we come in and we look at it as nothing. And church is the very thing that God wants to use to bring about your deliverance. Amen. See, some of y'all acting like you don't need no deliverance.
Amen.
Keep on acting. You ever heard your mom say, "Keep on acting"? I said, "Keep on acting. I got you here for a reason. I called you out for a purpose." Listen, I don't gotta know what you lay at night and pray for, but he do. I don't gotta know the pain that ache your heart, but he do. I don't gotta know how your bank account look. You can play it off to me all you want. I just seen brothers come to the shop to the toe, boy. Can't even give me a tip. Boy, all that baton you got on, because it ain't Louis, all that baton you got on. Play if you want to. Listen, you know how your money look. You know how your marriage look. You know how you want your marriage to look. You know how your friendship circle look. But not church. And God said, that's the very thing I'm going to use to bring about your deliverance. Watch this. Any of y'all ever been in a fight before? Come on, let's talk about it. Wait a minute, where's my church know when I take a drink, I mean, I'm finna go somewhere. Plus somebody say, "Get some drink, your mouth is white." Can I be honest? I'm trying to stall for the drink, amen? All right, man. Shout out to Libra, amen? Watch this. Any y'all ever been in a fight before?
Yeah.
That's like being in a fight in front of your house. And it's supposed to be a one-on-one. And all of a sudden, they try to jump you. Because the first thing you say to yourself is, no. Let me go in the house and get my brother. Huh? No. You ain't gonna jump me. Let me go in the house and get my brother. It's the same way in the supernatural. When the devil try to jump you with poverty, when the devil try to jump you with sickness, when the devil try to jump on your marriage, when the devil try to jump on your family, you gotta say, no. Let me go in the house and get some backup. You ain't just gonna jump on me like that. You know, grandma come out, baby, is they jumping over there? God, like, wait a minute, all this power in the house, and you struggling? Cause you tired? Cause you tired? Somebody say, I don't get tired. Look at your neighbor, tell,
I don't get tired.
Y'all, Kevin Gates wasn't the first one said that. I don't get tired. Listen. My wife and I was over $30,000 in debt. Yeah, I'm going to tell it again. We got paid 30 grand on stupid stuff. Just ain't no house or no car debt. Stupid stuff. Y'all, 30,000. And y'all, we was trying to do things on our own. We trying to, and we was getting jumped by bills all the time. But when I came into the house, and I asked somebody for wisdom, and they told me a thing about, I'm gonna say a curse word. But listen, I'm not saying it in the way that it sounds, but I'm gonna say this word. I feel the Lord lead me to say this word. So don't lose me, I'm gonna say this word. So when they start telling me about tithes, tithes, you cussing at me. Tell me about no tithes and no offering. But y'all, when I came in the house and the preacher started cussing me out right from the pulpit, telling me about tithes and offering, guess what? I gave it a chance. And then the power came. Because the Bible says that I'll rebuke the devourer for the tithe paid. I don't know about what you got going on, but I needed somebody to rebuke this stuff up off me. He eats up all the money. My God, the check is gone before I pull it out. You ever pulled your check out and half of it was just gone? But I had to come into the house to get the knowledge to know that he will rebuke the devourer for the tithe paid. I came in the house and said, listen, you ain't just gonna jump me like that. Let me go in the house and get my brothers. Let me go in the house and get some peace. Let me go in the house and get some healing. Let me go in the house and get a sound mind. Let me go in the house and get the power and the resources that dwell within my house. Anybody got a gun in the house? Hold on, with no heads, slow down. You might got some cops in here now. Because if you got a gun, you better show the conceal and carry. Because you're going to jail. I ain't gonna tell you who the cops is. But listen. Anybody ever been talking crazy to you? And you know you got that gun in the house? You know you got that fire in the house? You got your heat in the house? Me and one of my homies, we call it the spatula. You got your spatch on you? Because the spatula squash beat. That's what me and my homie call it. I ain't gonna call Theo name now, but that's what we call it. We call it the spatula.
Yes,
sir. Because spatula squash the beat. Yeah. Now here, let's get the scratch out. Listen, you know when you got power in the house, you can't wait to get to the house. You talking? Wait till I get home. Listen, that's how you need to be all during the week. I can't wait for Wednesday night. I can't wait for Sunday morning. Wait till I get home. And watch this. And if you take me out too bad, you don't want my daddy to come outside. Listen, let me tell you something right now. I ain't pumping weights for nothing. When Taylor get in school, you ain't gonna want Taylor daddy to come outside. I'm gonna tell you that right now. Cause Taylor daddy get up under some heavy weight. That's how it is when you come in, into the house of God. You gotta say to those demons, you don't want God to come outside and deal with your mess. Y'all, the power is in the house. That's why you wanna keep us away. I'm wrapping up right here, watch this. As long as the devil can keep you thinking that ain't no power in the house, you ain't gonna run to the house. You're not gonna run to a place that you don't see as a place of provision. You're not gonna run to a place that you don't see as a place of power. You run to a place that can do something for you. When you're lonely, you run to the club because I need to turn up. I need to lift my spirits, right? That's what you're supposed to do it for. But they clubbing for no reason now. They just going. Or when I have a relationship and I went over my wife's house. I needed something, not like that. I needed camaraderie, I needed friendship. That's what I'm saying. When you go over somebody's house, you can't wait to see him. Hey, grandma, this is what happens when you go to the house. But as long as he can keep you thinking, ain't no healing there, ain't no power there, ain't no deliverance there, ain't no friends there, ain't no community there. All they want is your money. That's all they want. Newsflash, everybody wants your money. That's how the apostle told me. McDonald's want your money. Gas station want your money. Cable want your money. Mortgage want your money. Car loan want your money. Kids want your money. Wife want your money. You want your money. Everybody wants your money. Primerica want your money. I ain't gonna tell you. Come on, let's get on something. Come on, man. We got some millionaires in the house. Come on, man. We got some millionaires in the house. Everybody wants your money. Watch this. Sometimes the very answer you're looking for is in a sermon that you missed. Let me say that again. Sometimes the very answer that you were looking for was in a sermon that you missed. or the piece that you were trying to get a hold to, God put it in the mouth of the speaker, but you couldn't get it because you wasn't in the house. Remember when all the other kids got something, you weren't there? Yeah, that's what's going on. The church folk get something, but guess what? You ain't there. You know that old lame thing they used to say? What's missing from the CH, blank, blank, CH? You are. They said that on Martin. Y'all ain't gonna watch Martin. That's what they said. I said it was lame, it ain't mine. But they said, what's missing from the church? What's missing from the CH, blank, blank, CH? You are. Everybody, the saints of God are realizing that now more than ever we need Christ. Y'all listen, I don't know how you can cut on the TV and think you don't need no church to go along with that. I don't know how you can watch whatever it is you're watching, thinking you don't need no church to go along with that. And the enemy wants to take the perception of the house. See, the problem with church is people don't know the difference between when they visit somebody's house and when they move into somebody's house. Huh? See, the problem with church is people don't know the difference from when they visit somebody's house and when they move in somebody's house, huh? See, when you visit somebody's house, just like the church, everybody nice when you visit. You know, hey, how you doing? Can I walk? Yeah, my house is your house. Can I go in the fridge? Of course, get you something, man. Please, my God. You're my last steak. Here, man, here. Because you're a visitor. The house is clean. You can't see a lot of, watch this, mess. Follow me. You can't see a lot of mess when you visited, because everything is clean and neatly tucked away. But when you move into somebody's house, similar to when you join the church, you start seeing things that you didn't see when you was a visitor.
Amen. Amen.
All right.
When you move into somebody's house, just like when you join the church, you start seeing things that you didn't see. Anybody ain't had on glittery Faith on Fire shirts? Yeah, I ain't seeing that no more. Everybody ain't smiling every day. Huh? And I'm noticing some things that haven't been cleaned up. Huh?
Amen.
And it begins to play on your perception of church.
Amen.
That's why people don't want to join. All they want to do is visit. Because I don't want to get antiquated with what's really going on in the house. See, if I can visit, people will love on me. I don't have to commit, and I can go about my merry way. But if I move in, any of y'all had somebody move in with you?
Amen.
Anybody ever had somebody move in with you?
Yes.
You start seeing things that maybe you didn't sit right with you. Now you notice people's bad habits. And everything that you thought was clean. But guess what? That don't mean it's a bad house. That just means they got some cleaning to do.
Amen.
Let me say that again. That don't mean it's a bad house because it got some junk and some mess. That just means we got some cleaning to do. But the enemy has told people that because they see some stuff out of line and because they see some stuff out of order, that it's a bad house. That's a lie from the prince of hell. And that's how he's keeping people away from the church. Yes, I'll be the first one to admit that the church has got some cleaning up to do. Listen, y'all. The church house got some cleaning up to do. But so does the White House. Huh?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
But so does the courthouse.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
So does my house. And most importantly, so does your house.
Yes.
Now, don't let the devil trick you into overlooking the very thing that God is going to use to bring about the instrument of your deliverance. Let me say that to you again. Don't let the devil continue. Y'all, listen, we're looking up and we're 35. And we got but a little bit. We're looking up and we're 40. And we got but half of a little bit. Y'all, we don't got time to waste. No, I mean, listen, how much turn up can we do?
Come on.
I'm going to be honest. Can you ever turn it all the way up? And then it don't go no more, right? Some of y'all done turned up. Y'all ain't going no more. Out there, listen, that's it. They got to keep switching the dance. You got a Billy Rock, you got a Stanky Leg, you got a Dougie. They got to keep switching up, because that's it. Ain't no peace in that mess. Ain't no real power in that mess. Ain't no understanding, ain't no wisdom, ain't no knowledge. And watch this, deep down on the inside, we know it. but it's like a drug. We do it like euphoria. I just want to block out the reality of